Some people worry a lot. Have I got the perfect master or not? There's no way to find out. How will we find out? It doesn't matter. If you're a seeker, you're bound to meet a perfect living master. And when you meet the perfect living master, all the effort you have made anywhere is transferred to the perfect living master. There's nothing ever lost, great master explained to us. So this is so remarkable that people who used to worry about these things, the only requirement on the spiritual path for a seeker is to seek as intensely as possible, with as much love and devotion as possible, with as quietly as possible in the heart, in the mind, nowhere else. You don't have to go out in the streets and shout, I want God. You have to shout inside yourself. Shout in your head. Shout in your heart. I want it. I'm fed up with this. I want more. I want to go home. When you say that in your heart, you're destined to meet a perfect living master. If not right today, tomorrow, day after, next year, 10 years later, next life. But you're bound to meet one. Therefore, this is a ritual for the masters, that they watch the marked souls coming up to them. They know where the souls have been. They know how much progress they made in the past life, how much they made in the years before they came to us. They take all that into account. That is why, after initiation, people complain that our progress is not the same as that guy's. How come every time there's an exercise, people jump and see in the thing, they fly in the sky, and we can't even take our feet off the ground? Because each person is different. People have worked in the past. They worked in a past life. It all accumulates to give you an advantage. You're all standing at different positions on the road to spirituality and enlightenment. And those positions, you are given the methods to move on from that position. Masters give a discourse, and 50 people are listening to the discourse, and each one is getting a different message. And when they compare notes, they say, Master said this. No, he said something else. They all heard something different. Why did they hear different when the Master said the same thing? Because they were ready only for some part of it. They were ready to assimilate that part which was needed by them. It is not for everybody that everybody responded the same way. It's just like the book you are talking about. It's just like you hear a song once, second time it means more. You read a verse, second time it means more.